I've gained some altitude. 7-2.
7-1. 7-2. 7-2. I still. You're just right off my right.
I'm out of luck. Didn't lift the cage for me, but definitely don't have this thermal burner. Come on. Here. You need about 7,500 across that bridge.
I'm hoping this big black cloud will give me some wind. Not on landing
Terribly fast. There's actually a little ridge here that rises behind the main ridge. I'm getting lift coming up off of that. It's sinking off the back side of the island.
Well, I topped out at about 12, but I'm gliding now. Looks really good. I'm back up to 11.2. Then this lift in the start circle. That's nice to have lift right there in the start. I'm in the tanks circle. I just got tanks. I'm heading for cross now. Yeah, the turn points seem to be working just fine for me.
Looks like. Yeah, I'm heading for that next bunch of clouds. Hope I find something along the way. I am getting little bits of ridge lift off the tank. Boy, getting down to 10,000. Almost 10-1. Got one little puffy in front of me, but it's evaporating in front of my eye.
I'm making a fly to the fly range up.
Oh, you're off my right wing tip. We're both making fly to that same time. Weird, it seems like these thermals are better at the peripheral edge of the cloud than they are actually under them. At least for these really big ones. Kind of makes sense because it's probably where the sunlight's hitting the ground down here that is actually heating and lifting into the cloud. Ooh, there's a little turbulence. I got out into the, I'm right crossing over the top of the Cross Mountain. Got turbulence in. Gonna try to visually pick up 40. I don't see it yet. I gotta get a little further out. I have one dirt road. And a big blue hole, man. Big blue hole.
Black cloud over tanks now as far over across as I'm coming over. I should be able to just scream across tank or across mountains. And then there's a big blue hole.
Yeah. That big blue hole essentially goes almost all the way to Steamboat, but there are little bits of puffy out there.
They aren't.
Thank you. You look to be fine. Have you passed Hayden yet?
Oh, yeah.
I now see Hayden and Craig and the highway showing up. I haven't even passed Hayden. Should get there higher.
But I got a 40-to-1 flight.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Your arrival should hike higher.
I'm now at 300 feet.
Is the ski area got kind of some like snow-capped mountains on it?
It does.
I can see that.
miles out. ...13-1 glide. I see the flashing lights of the airport. This should be it. 0.2... ...0.1... Task finished.
I'm just coming up on the Eagle Airport. See an airport marker, but that doesn't look like Eagle Airport. It's like somebody in church, but... Yeah, like 3, 2. One.
I do not see you. Like, physically, do not see you.
Zero. I'm just crossing over the airport.
And I'm... Hey, guys. Thanks for watching another Hang Gliding Files adventure video. What we were trying to do with this particular video is show you our evaluation of cloud formation and development in the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Those clouds tied to thermals. The thermals are newly added to the whole simulator, and we're giving them a good test today. And a really good evaluation of the graphics settings, the graphics that we think we're going to be able to get in our future hang gliding videos at our current settings. If you'd like to retry this flight that we just did in a sailplane or any other soaring craft, the links below will give you the XCSoar task file or the Microsoft Flight Plan. Our next steps for this is going to be, first we're going to probably film some other adventures using other aircraft like bush planes and other things to get a feel for low level flying in mountains and see what kind of graphics we get in that. We need to build us some actual hang gliders. Nobody else is going to do it. We're going to have some software that we need to build that allows us to fly those hang gliders. Going to have to also build hang gliding sites. Hang gliders don't fly from airports, and everything in this sim currently needs to fly from an airport of some sort. And then last but not least is we're going to film some of these flights in VR, and we'd like to take you along on that journey and maybe do some 360 degree videos. Anyhow, I hope you guys like where we're going with this channel. If you do, like and subscribe. We try to post once a week, but that depends on our schedules and what kind of flying we get done. Okay, well, that's it for today. See you guys next week.